Hi, welcome back to Minecrack. More videos for you. You sitting back eating potato chips in your chair, doing nothing productive for the world. Just doing nothing. Just kidding. I'm glad you're here. Thanks for watching. Now, let's go do something. Shut up. Oh, let me first clear my inventory. I've talked to you about a few things. I've been doing some things off camera here. Some necessary off camera things for off of the camera. As you can see, there are... I can't believe that I just heard a cat. I can't believe this right now. Do it. No talking here. The town hall in a chest. I thought that I had the cat situation taken care of. I can't believe I just heard that. Jay Sano, the bane of my existence. The bane of my arthropods. If you don't understand what we've got going here, those were materials from the bridge that I took down. What do you say? 2 blocks of glowstone. Okay. Hi, visitors. Company. I didn't ask for company, but we'll take it. So, Jay Sano, you nasty guy. I cannot find those cats. I silenced 3 cats today? Let's say silenced. And I thought that was all of them. But it most certainly was not. You know what? That's right. Don't even try to intimidate me with that hissing. No way. So the bridge is gone. We're going to do something better. The cyan was just making a really strange transition into town here. And Etho kind of did the same thing. I think he was feeling the same thing I'm feeling now. So we're going to change it up, and I've got some cool ideas. I think it's going to work out nice. So we will put these in here for the new Minecracker. And let's quickly talk about Town Hall here. So I put these curtains on the walls. I think they look pretty cool, actually. I messed around with a lot of different colors, and some colors worked. This was the one that I kind of liked the best. I think it felt the best for me. As far as lighting, we've got several trouble areas. We've got there, 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 and there. Those torches are pretty well hidden, so I'm okay with those. But it's those few spots that I've got to get taken care of somehow, some way, and I'm not exactly sure. I also finished the roof. I debated a lot on what to do. I had tried different materials, and for this being survival, I just continued to go with that wood. There were things I liked better. Oh man, decked out in diamonds already, are you? Woo-hoo! Good for you. I cannot say who that is, just to let you know. But anyway, it's coming along. It's coming along. We're getting there. I'll show you the finished product of the catacombs, too. Yeah, they will from time to time. Still working on it. So here's a finished product. Here's Ethos when I murdered him in the death games. There's his face and his little mask. And I guess that should be something different, but maybe something like this. Maybe gunpowder. But yeah, the things have grown down. The vines have grown down, and I think it's nice. I got the ceiling all finished, so I think it looks cool down here. But we spent enough time in the darkness yesterday. Did he get these? Right there. Oh, okay. Nice. Fix that. There's a lot of spots where they can spawn, actually, my friend. But we could put some stuff down in here too. Who is this guy coming on brand new? I bring over some glowstone? No prob. Good gravy. Okay, but so that's where we're at on the town hall. I just gotta wrap up this front area here and kind of figure out how that end is gonna close off, and then we're good. Just figure out the lighting, which isn't gonna be too big of a problem. I'm pretty happy with it. I think it'll be cool. So, let's check the death games real quick. Generic's been in there. Yep, he's been in there all day. But okay, so here's my idea for this bridge here. Let's work this out together. I want it to be 48. 48 wide, which should get us to over there. So if we go like so, and we go, watch this. This creates such a cool curve, and in messing with it, three, four, five, in messing with it, it almost gave me this weird feeling like the wood was really bowing. Two, three, four, five. Two. So we're gonna try to create that effect again. It's five, five, seven, three. This is 48 wide, so we're unfortunately gonna have to have an even number here. Four, five, six, seven. One, two. But we'll live with it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I got skills, baby. I ain't falling down. No way, no how. So this is gonna be our curve. I have to put the two half slabs under that one, but you're gonna be pretty amazed at how much this looks like a natural bowing curve. It's cray cray. Bam! Shut up! Boom, boom. All right, let's check this out. It's crazy. Up we go, up we go, up we go. And look at that. I mean, the background stuff kind of distracts from it. But that is a really nice curve. With it being a bridge, if we want it to look somewhat realistic, we don't want the bridge to be too drastic and too crazy. And I think I do want to go for a little bit of realism here on this. I don't want to go too fantasy, too crazy, too much. But that curve is pretty nice, I think. I like that line. Look at that, how that flow. That flows nice. I like it. So I'm going to do some more work on this bridge here. I think this is going to be something that I'm going to continue to work on for quite some time. I'm also going to take out all of this row. It's going to give us a lot of cyan clay, which is great because I end up using it in a lot of places. I'm going to take it all the way out to here, and then I'll just continue that road style with the gravel and the other materials. I'll continue that on through here over and connect to Doc so Doc has a road straight to spawn. He's away in London right now. So I've been doing a lot of digging over there, a ton of digging to try to help him out. I'd love to surprise him when he gets back, but I don't think I'm going to be able to. I wanted to think, see if I could finish it, but I certainly can't do that. But anyway, I'm going to keep working on this bridge, and I'll be right back with you. I put 6 here. You think I didn't see that, huh? You think I didn't notice that? You think I didn't realize I have to redo the whole entire bridge over and over? You didn't think I saw that, did you? I saw it. Don't worry. Why did this work? Why did this work if I did 6 there? Maybe 6 there is okay, but I did 6 there. Why didn't I? How many did I do here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What in the heck? I did 6 over here, didn't I? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Why did this work? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. What's going on? Generic B joined the game just as I start recording again. Good morning. This is the next day now. I always like, you know, the next day thing. That's always nice because you get to, just in case you're off. Last night I was recording and I was like, do I sound tired? Maybe I sound tired. So now, did I tell you I bought one? I bought a chest plate from Doc here. I got the 3 stacks of clay, and I put them in there for Doc. So, hey, here we go. Here we go with the Doc. Speaking of Docs, oh, this is a bridge, though. So this is it. Now, you may look at this and think, bleh, gross. And I kind of think so, too, kind of. But more appealing to me than anything is the fact that it's different. It's just not one same thing all the way through. It's kind of different. Forces you to use your imagination a little bit to kind of make you think, oh, there's some darker planks and some lighter planks, you know? So I'm going to keep it. Even though I might not love it. I really tried to break up the pattern so it doesn't look like a checkerboard. Hurrying potion is spider eye, then fermented spider eye. I think that or healing and fermented. I could be wrong. But anyway, yeah, here it is. Here it is, completed, finished. Kind of. I think this is something we will revisit from time to time. It'll have different stages. Maybe we'll add things. Like maybe a little area where you could walk down, have a little deck there that you could fish off of. Possibly. I don't know if fishing from that high up would be very beneficial. Like if the fish would come back to you. Fishing is beneficial. You could fish here, you know, eat pretty easily. Even here you could fish, but I doubt you'd get the fish back. Yeah, but that's the bridge, and I've kind of tied it into the road here. I've got some of the planks kind of continuing off. Some people aren't going to like it, and that's okay. That's okay. I think depending on when I would view this video, I might not like it myself, but right now I do. And I think from this distance, the bridge looks good. I definitely like it better. It has, certainly has much more character than the old bridge that I had there. So I'm happy with it. I think it's good. So I tore up my entire road to my house. It's all tore up, all the way down, and that's several stacks of cyan clay, which is awesome. We've got like 6 or 7 stacks of that stuff now. But I'm just going to redo this road in kind of this pattern minus the wood, and probably bring it up like here is when it'll come up a level. But I think it's going to be good. I think it's going to turn out nice. I've got the two torches at the beginning, and I think I'll do something a little more interesting to put some light there. I don't know if these posts are going to stay or how that's going to work. Later. But anyway, I think this is good for now. Good start, at least. But the rest of the bridge is all spawn-proof as far... No, it's not. No, it's not. That needs light. That needs light. I'm going to leave it. Zisto was talking about this in one of his latest videos, that there's different play styles in the game regarding light. And I suppose... I suppose, maybe out of consideration for others, maybe I should have it all lit up. I tend to be a fan of having dark areas for ambiance, like how in the catacombs it's nice and dark. Luckily, nothing can spawn down there, but I like having dark areas. You know, if everything's bright, but then you come to this bridge and it's all dark at night. Could be kind of cool. The problem is, this is a community thing, and I imagine creepers blowing up on this quite often. I don't know. I also like when people... I mean, for myself, I like when mobs will just spawn out of nowhere. It gives you something interesting to do. It gives you a little fight that you gotta put up from time to time, you know? So anyway, we'll see. We'll debate about it a little bit in my brain. Me and my brain, we gonna fight. Etho's in, but he's not on. So let's go back into the town hall. Talking a little bit about the lighting situation in here, right? So I've got some of it sorted out. New Minecracker was saying that there was some spawning spaces here. He was actually wrong. I think he was wrong, because you look at the second line from the bottom on the left, it says planes. Right next to that, it says BL. I think that's the block light, and I think that's the light that says, that's how much light is on that block. And I learned this from my basement, okay? So if your lighting is all up here, and you're reading, oh, it's level 7 at my head, right? Let's say the BL was 7. That would mean that down here, the light diminishes. This would be 6. But if your light is coming from down here, and at your head it says 7, this would be 8. And all of the blocks around here were 7. I accidentally just said the new Minecracker's name. Whoops! let me just recap. I don't know where I have to cut. But anyway, the new Minecracker assumed that the block or the lighting was coming from the ceiling. But the fact that maybe it's... said block light 7 here, it was actually 8 on the ground because the light is coming from here. So I think we're okay. Man, I'm gonna have to, that footage might be a little crazy. I don't know. you guys will find out very soon though, so don't freak out or don't worry. Anyway, so let's talk about some more lighting situations. Luckily, I was able to put a piece of glowstone right here, and that was able to take care of this spot. We're looking at 10 right up in here, so this is all good. These are all half slabs, so not worried about that. Down here is all good. See, this is a great... Not worried about this, because this is a half slab, but this says 7, but if we dig down, it's saying 8, and I think it reads whatever your head is at. So I think we're okay. I don't know. If mobs spawn in here, I'm glad. I hope it blows people up. I'm just kidding. But So now this spot, right? We've got this torch here that we got to get taken care of. And I've decided, I think I want to do kind of a pattern in this area. And then maybe tuck some glowstone in. I think that'll be cool. So we'll work that out. Bam. Bam. One, two, three. Bam, bow, bing, bong, boom, bing, bang, bong. And there we go. Give me that. Very good. And boop. And boop. And boop. And we want all the blocks. Give me those. I'm going to sneeze. Any minute now, I'm going to sneeze. I feel it. Sniff it out. There we go. All right, let's take out all this, actually. Because we can do kind of a little circle design pattern that I think we could pop some glowstone in. And maybe even just do like a rug type thing. Possibly. So we'll take out that. I'll take out this other one. And we'll just kind of... I'll get all the materials together because I'm going to need some other materials around here. I'll get those together. And we'll come back here and we'll work out a little design. Fricker, man! Dang, crap. Ouch. What did I drop? I guess that was just cobblestone right there. Hello. There we go. Alright, so I'll be back with you in just a bit. Alrighty, so I think this here is a pattern I can get around. And a little glowstone there ain't hurting anybody, I don't think. If anything, I think it's helping everybody. Let's see. We all good? We all good? I think we're good. We're good. We're good. We're good. And we got a 7. But we're good. We're good. I think that's cool. I think that's cool. Okay, so let's work this design out on the other side. Together as a team. Friends to the end. I don't have enough dirt to make this happen. Yeah, I wanted to work the design off camera. Just to see. Just to see. Can you do it, B-dubs? Can you do it all by yourself? And I can, looks like. Okay. So, center. Right? We find the center. We go like this. 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 And this. And that wasn't the center. And this. And this. And this. There we go. Redo. Boom. Boom. That's the center. Okay? And then we're going to go corner, 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 corner. Good? I'm happy with that. Next move is going to be... Aha! Stairs like a soul. So we're going to take stairs and we're going to put them on these corners here. Boom, 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 boom. Give me that. This is a good spot for this this kind of design here. I like this. And then we'll take some of these bad boys. Ba-bam. Not there, I don't think, actually. Boom. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Okay. And then next, in these corners, we got just regular cobblestone. And then boom, boom. Got it. I follow. Regular cobblestone. Regular cobblestone. Regular. Regular. Very good. And boom, 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 boom. And we're going to have to make... another set of stairs here. There we go. Mm-hmm. That's going to go like that, that, that. Yeah, so this, it's more of an... I like the way this looks here, because this is just more of a little bit of a intricate design in the floor, which I think works out pretty well for this spot. And at the same time, it takes care of our lighting issue. And I don't think it causes any sort of problem, really. If we really don't like it, we could attempt to do something like a so. And that could potentially... I don't like how that looks. I prefer to just have the piece of glowstone showing there. I like that better. Glowstone showing. Great! So we've pretty much got this thing down to having a couple torches hidden there and there, which you rarely see, and then one torch over there, and everything else is lit. So really only one torch, one spot that needs addressing. And man, if I wish I knew how to take care of that. I mean, we could. We could just go like this. Boom, boom. Take that out. Why is this? Wait a sec. Oh, I see what's going on. Yeah. Boom. So we could. I think we only need one, really. Just right there. Yeah, we do. And could just put a rug here. Problem solved. I think that does it. I think the entire place is spawn-proof now. Yeah, that ain't that bad a deal there. That is okay. Could even put something different here, but for now that works. That works. So I'm happy. We are safe with the lighting. We got a cool little design in the floor that leads to that. I like that much better than what we had before. That goes there. If we really wanted to do this, we could go and flip these. Flip it and reverse it. Bop, bop, bop. Hey, get out of there. I saw that. You think I didn't see that? Bam. There we go. So we could go like so. And that's not bad either. Yeah. Let me know what you guys think. This one? Yeah? Or the other one? Boop. There we go. This one? Or this one? This one or this one? Great. Awesome! So, we've got all the stuff taken care of here. We've got the bridges taken care of. Now, the next thing that I'd really like to do, and I don't think this is going to be next episode, I'm not going to show, actually, what I did today, because Speedy, my friend, says that he watches the start of my video, and then skips to the end, and watches the end of my video. So he is forced to watch the entire video and be tortured. I'm not going to show what I did. Perfect. but what I'd like to do, this spawn area, look at the torches. Bam, 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 bam. Torches everywhere. I don't think this is something that we're going to be able to avoid. I think there's going to have to be torches and lighting all over the place. But I'd really like to at least get the torches off the road. So I'd like to make all the roads spawn proof for hostiles by putting in some street lights. Show me them street lights! And we'll work out a design and get those up and running next episode. So shut up! Hopefully you guys enjoyed. I know I sure did. I did make some changes here to the old house. I think we're going to leave her upside down for a little while, but we want to have a nice stairway here that you can get in. So, all right, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'm going to take off and do things off camera, and we'll see you next episode.